neza.
God bless you so much, Professor. And may God increase for you.
Ejo Professor arifuza kuzabonana n'abantu bose bize mu ishuri ya INT kuri Grand Legacy saa 10.
Tomorrow, Professor Vincent will be holding a meeting with all the alumni of INT at 4 p.m. at Grand Legacy Hotel.
Grand Legacy abize muri INT mwese muzahure nawe.
Those who studied in INT, all the Oxids, meet him at 4 p.m. at Grand Legacy.
Abashumba bose ba Zion Temple.
All the pastors of Zion Temple.
Ejo tuzaba turi kumwe dufite kongre izatangira saa 3 kugeza nyuma ya saa 6.
We're inviting all the pastors of Zion Temple for a pastor's congress that we'll have tomorrow at the church from 9 a.m. to the afternoon.
Ikindi tuzaba dufite inteko rusange idasanzwe.
We'll have a special general assembly tomorrow.
Abapasiteri bacu saa 3 kugeza saa 7.
All our pastors from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m.
Zion Temple na Afrika guruka zojuje imyaka 20.
Zion Temple and Africa Arise are celebrating 20 years anniversary.
Agira ngo tuyiririmbire isabukuru nziza.
I'd like us to sing a happy birthday song.
Hanyuma turaza, murabona dufite umutsimani imbere munini cyane.
We have a big cake here.
Hanyuma turaza njyewe na madame uyu mutsima ucamo tu celebrating imyaka 20.
And me and my wife will be cutting the cake shortly, as they say. We wish you more years, Zion Temple. We wish you greatness. We wish you success. We wish you to be blessed. We wish you to be empowered.
And
glory to our living God.
Benedata.
Our brothers. And sisters, here we are about to conclude our conference. The theme of this conference was in Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 10.
Ivuga kw'abantu bazava hakurya y'uruzi y'inzuzi za Ethiopia abaramyi b'Uwiteka bukuri.
And the verse says, from beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, my worshippers, the daughter of my dispersed ones, shall bring my offering. Psalm 68:31.
Bibiliya iravuga ngo imfura zizava muri Egiputa ngo kandi ikusha ari Ethiopia ngo nayo izaramburira Imana amaboko.
The Bible says in Psalm 68:31, nobles shall come from Egypt, Cush shall hasten them to stretch out her hands to God.
Ibi nibyo Imana ivuga bizaba muri ibi bihe.
This is what God is saying that will happen in this season.
Turitegura ko hari ibintu bikomeye Imana igiye kuzadukorera.
We are believing and trusting that God is going to do great things for us.
Turizera ko Imana igiye kwibuka Afrika mu bundi buryo.
And we know that God is about to remember Africa in another dimension.
Profeti amaze kutubwira abaramya Imana yifuza.
Prof has told us the worshippers that God is looking for. According to the book of Revelation, I will not go back to that because he has mentioned it. But I want to remind you the greatest challenge that Africa has had. And we still have today. In Jeremiah 24:10, the Bible says, and I will send the sword, the famine and the pestilence among them, till they are consumed from the land that I gave to them and to their fathers.
Ngo kugeza igiye bose barangiriye ngo ndetse n'igihugu Imana yabahaye bakivanywemo. Iyo ureba ibirimo biba muri Afrika, iri jambo ingota, inzara na mugiga byagiye bigaruka muri bibiliya kenshi igihe cy'abahanuzi.
When you look at what is happening in Africa, these three words, the sword, the famine, and the pestilence, have showed up many times in the Bible, especially in the time of the prophets, and we see these things in Africa.
In Jeremiah 14:11-12,
the Bible says, then the Lord said to me, do not pray for these people, for they are good.
Hari igihe muri Israel Imana yavuze ngo ndi wongere gusengera aba bantu.
When they fast, I will not hear their cry. And when they offer burnt offerings and grain offering, I will not accept them. But I will consume them by the sword, by the famine, and by the pestilence.
Ninzara na mugiga akandi Imana yonge kuvuga ibi bintu ko ari bitatu no muri Yeremiya muri Ezekiel 24:21.
We see that these words are recurring in the scripture, the sword, the famine, and the pestilence. Even in Ezekiel 14:21, the Bible says, for thus says the Lord God, how much more it shall be when I send my four severe judgments on Jerusalem, the sword, the famine, and wild beasts and pestilence to cut off man.
Ngwese bizamera gute ngo ninohereze ibintu bine ahayo ngo icyakane aravuga ngo ingota, inzara, inyamaswa nkazi ngo ndetse na mugiga ngo ibyo bizakuraho abantu. Muri Yeremiya 32:24.
In Jeremiah 32:24, the Bible says, look, the siege mounts. They have come to the city to take it. And the city has been given into the hand of the Chaldeans who fight against it. Because of the sword and famine and pestilence. What you have spoken has happened.
Bavuze ngo byarabaye. Iyo tureba turabona ibi bihanda bitatu bikomeye.
So we see these three giants.
Igihanda cy'ingota.
We see the giant of the sword.
Igihanda cy'inzara.
We see the giant of famine.
Turabona n'igihanda cya mugiga arizo ndwara.
And the giant of pestilence or disease.
Iyo Bibiliya ivuga ingota, ibivuga intambara.
When the Bible speaks of the sword, the Bible is speaking about battles and war.
Iyo Bibiliya ivuga inzara, ibivuga ubukene.
When the Bible is speaking about famine, the Bible is speaking about hunger and poverty. When he's speaking about famine, he's speaking about poverty. When the Bible talks about pestilence, the Bible is talking about the disease that will come and wipe numbers of people. People die, perish. In the book of Joshua 15:13-14,
13-14, the Bible says, now to Caleb, the son of Jephna, he gave a share among the children of Judah, according to the commandment of the Lord to Joshua. To Joshua, namely
Kiriath Arba,
which is Hebron. Arba was the father of Anak.
Arba yarise wa Anaki.
Caleb drove out the three sons of Anak from there.
Ngwakuraho ngibihanda bitatu abyirukana uyu Caleb.
Sheshai,
ikihana chambere chitwaga Sheshai,
Ahiman,
ichakabiri Ahiman,
Talmai,
ichakatatu Talmai,
the children of Anak,
ibizari bihanda bitatu bene Caleb, abo Caleb yakuye ku musozi wa Hebron.
These were three giants that Caleb moved from the mountain of Hebron.
Umunsi binjiye mu gihugu
cy'isezerano. When they entered the promised land,
hari yakeneye umuntu uja ku musozi.
There needed a person to stand at the mountain.
Kugira ngo ufate.
But the mountain had three giants. And these are likened to a true worshipper who have to go to the different mountains in Africa, who have the heart of Caleb different from other people's hearts. And these giants were powerful. The sons of Anak,
Sheshai,
Sheshai,
Ahiman,
Ahiman, Talmai, they are compared to the swarm. They are compared to the famine and the pestilence. Who can dare to go to the peak of the mountain like Caleb and destroy these giants? We need this Savior. Let's look at how Africa is doing with poverty and hunger.
Africa ni umugabane munini cyane ufite abantu benshi batuye mu bukene.
Africa is the continent with the largest number of people living in extreme poverty.
Miliyoni 383 y'Abanyafrika babeshejweho n'amafaranga.
With 383 million people living on less than $1.90 per day. Those are the facts.
Miliyoni 383 babeshejweho n'amafaranga angana n'igihumbi 800 y'amanyarwanda.
383 million Africans are living on less than $1.90 per day.
Miliyoni 319 y'Abanyafrika bari munsi ya Sahara, abo bose bafite ikibazo cy'amazi meza.
319 million people in sub-Saharan Africa are without access to improved, reliable drinking water resources.
Pame cyangwa se ibigeranyo bya Pame byo mu mwaka wa 2014 na 2015 byagaragaje yuko miliyoni 233 y'Abanyafrika bari munsi ya Sahara, abo bose bafite ikibazo cy'imirire, barya nabi cyangwa se ntibarya.
233 million people in sub-Saharan Africa were undernourished according to the 2014-2016 UN Food and Agriculture Organization report.
Africa ifite miliyari imwe na miliyoni 200 y'abaturage.
Africa has 1.2 billion.
Bivuga ko mu bantu bane muri Africa umwe yicwa n'inzara cyangwa se arya nabi.
Which means one of the four people will be undernourished or severely hungry.
Wibuke ko isi yose uyu munsi mbabwira miliyoni 985 nibo barya nabi, ariko miliyoni hafi 319 iba muri Africa.
I want to remind you that there are 795 million undernourished people worldwide, according to the same UNFAO report, and a half of that lives in Africa. Why? We have a problem of famine. We have a problem of pestilence. We have a problem of war. We find these three things mentioned in the scriptures many times. In the past year, so many nations across the world would find ways to fight famine. They had gods against famine. They called them the gods of of fertility. They would have the god of war. Whenever they would go to battle, they would have to give offerings to the god of war. There was also the god of health. They would perform some customs on sick people and believe that according to their God, these things happened for so many years. Even in Africa, there is a time in France where people would eat each other because of hunger. There is a time in America when the first people who discovered they found the natives and they had plenty to harvest and they shared the harvest and they had the turkey. After sharing the
turkey,
and they started celebrating Thanksgiving. They till today Americans celebrate Thanksgiving Day. Because the greatest challenge human beings face is food. When people give you what to eat, you can worship them. Because hunger is a serious problem. So today, as I speak
about
hunger, so many countries have solved the problem of famine and hunger. And many nations have solved the problems of disease. So many nations have solved the problems of war. Those three giants are last remaining in Africa. Where is the greatest hunger? It is in Africa. Where is the greatest war? It is in Africa. Where are people so sick? It is in Africa. There is no other continent where you find Ebola.
Africa.
There is no other continent you find malaria except in Africa.
Ndawundi mugabane basangamo sida yarenza abantu ni muri
Africa. There is no other continent you find HIV AIDS like in Africa.
Africa ufite umugabane w'impfuzi nyinshi ziruta izabandi batewe n'intambara ariko basigajwe na sida. Ibyo se muri Uganda abantu benshi bakuze imiryango yabo yarashize n'ibindi bice byinshi bya Africa. Ndahandi tubisangane muri Africa.
Africa is the continent where you find the children who were orphaned because of HIV AIDS compared to other nations where children were orphaned because of war. Why do we have war? Why do we have famine? Why do we have diseases? There is a problem. And Professor has answered
it.
We need true worship on the seventh
tiers.
We don't need people who go to work. We need people who go to worship truly on the mountains.
It's not a matter of a job. We need a matter of a worship. They need to worship God instead of going to job. It's not job. It's worship. I'm going to pray. I'm going to pray. I'm going to pray. I'm going to pray.
We have a problem of people who show up to work, but they are not true worshippers. It's not a problem of having a job. It's a problem of serving God in true worship, in the way you work and in the way you work with other people. Let me come back to what Jesus said. Matthew 24 verse 3. The Bible says, now as he sat on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately, saying, tell us, when will these things be? And what will be the sign of your coming? At the end of age. And Jesus answered and said to them, take heed that no one deceives you. For many will come in my name, saying, I am the
their Christ and will deceive many. Verse 7, for nation will rise against nation.
Imperuka aravuga ngo amahanga ishanga rizahagurukira irindi cyanga iyo ni ingota izo ni intambara
and kingdom against kingdom
ubwami buhagurukira ubundi bwami
and there will be famines
ngo kandi hazaba inzara
pestilences
hazaba ibyorezo
earthquakes
hazaba imitingito
in various places
hirya no hino
all these are the beginning of sorrow
ibi byose ngo nukuramukwa ku murongo wa 14
verse 14 and this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world
ngo ubu butumwa bw'ubwami buzigishwa mu isi yose
as a witness to all the nations
ngo abahamiriza abahanga
and then the end will come
ngo nyuma yaho imperuka izisubiramo ku murongo wa 14
Verse 14.
In this gospel of the kingdom.
And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world. As a witness to all the nations. And then the end will come.
Ngo hanyuma imperukize. Reka mbabwire rero. Nuwuhe mugabane usigaranye ibi bibazo ko ari bitatu ibi bihanga bitatu.
What is the continent that has these three giants I just told you?
Ni Africa.
It is Africa.
Africa niyo tukigira abantu bakibura.
Africa is where we find people who go hungry and sleep without food.
Africa niyo tukigira abantu barwara indwara.
This is where we have people who get sick and have no treatment.
Africa niyo tukigira abantu barwana bicana.
In Africa, that's where people are rising against each other and killing each other. When you look at the wars that have taken place in Africa, it is very sad. Jesus connected it to the second coming. He connected this to the second coming and the end of the world.
Yes, aravuga ngo.
Jesus says,
hazaba inzara.
There will be famine.
Hazaba ibiza.
There will be pestilences and earthquakes.
Hazaba indwara.
There will be pestilences.
Yes, aravuga ngo. Hazaba inkota.
Jesus said, there will be swords.
Ubwami buzarwana n'ubwami.
Kingdom will rise against kingdom.
Ishyanga rirwane n'irindi.
Nation will rise against nation.
Ubu mbabwira ibindi bihugu byasinyanye ama agreement yo kutarwana.
As I speak, other countries have signed agreements to never attack each other.
Ubwongereza n'Uburayi bararangije intambara hashize imyaka ijana irenga. Imyaka magana arenga.
The United Kingdom and Europe have signed agreements and they will never fight each other.
Ubutage bwavuze ko butazongera gukora intwaro buracecetse ntacyo butwaye ibindi bihugu.
And Germany signed the agreement to never manufacture weapons.
America ifite ubushobozi bwo gukora intwaro za kirimbuzi zikomeye ariko yarabihagaritse.
America has the power to create weapons of mass destruction, but they have stopped doing it.
Uburusiya na Amerika hari ibyo bumvikanye nubwo ubu barimo bashaka kubivamo ariko ntibashobora gukora ibyo abantu bifuza ko bakora ubu kuko bafite ubwenge bahagaritse intambara.
And the same applies to the agreement that the United States had with Russia, but till today, with all their struggles, they still can't fight.
Biragoye ibindi bihugu ntushobora kubona perezida cyangwa se abaminisitiri batinya ko abaturage babica nk'ino muri ibi bihugu byacu usanga abantu bahiga abayobozi babo.
There are countries where the people will not be afraid, or that the leaders of the country will not be afraid that the people will kill them compared to African countries.
Ministre wa mbere wa Denmark.
The first minister of Denmark.
Azaje guhaha akaje muri supermarché ni gare akagura ibiryo agataha. Umunsi umwe yagize ibyago umusore umuta mukunza amutera amagi amumenekaho. Ntacyo bamutwaye ariruka afata akagari karagenda. Uwo niwe perezida w'igihugu. Abaturage acya mu baturage nk'uko cya mu bandi bantu ibintu by'intambara z'amakudeta ntabikihaba. Ibyo biri muri Afrika gusa.
The Prime Minister of Denmark goes to the market and he rides his bicycle and goes and shops and comes back. And one day a young man threw eggs at him and he picked his bicycle and went. But in Africa, leaders do not go on the street anyhow. They are afraid to be killed. Coup d'etats only happen in Africa. It's only in Africa where nations rise against nations. What did Jesus say about it? He connected it to the end of the world. And he spoke of the gospel that will be preached. Jesus said, in the time of the famine,
muri ico gihe cy'inkota,
in the time of the swarm,
muri ico gihe cy'indwara,
in the time of pestilence,
ngo hazahaguruka ubutumwa bw'ubwami.
There will be a gospel of the kingdom.
Hazahaguruka ubutumwa bw'ubwami.
There will be a gospel of the kingdom.
Nukuvuga ko ubutumwa bw'ubwami bufite imizi muri Afrika kandi nibwo buzarangiza ubundi butumwa.
Which means the gospel of the kingdom is rooted to Africa or in Africa and it will move all other gospels.
Kubera iki?
Why?
Ubutumwa bw'ubwami,
the gospel of the kingdom,
ni ubutumwa bushyira Yesu muri buri sekiteri y'ubuzima.
Is a gospel that establishes Jesus in every sphere of life.
Mu bucuruzi,
in business,
mu gipolisi,
in the police,
mu gisirikare,
in the army,
mu burezi,
in education,
Imana ikabamo.
For God to dwell there,
mu baganga,
in the medical,
mu bashakashatsi,
in the researchers,
mu bavumbuzi,
in the inventors field,
mu bahinzi,
in the agriculture,
mu borozi,
in the farmers.
Abo nibo bagomba kumera nka Kalebu bagakuraho ibi bihanda bitatu ku musozi wa Hebron.
They have to rise like Caleb and move this giant on the mountain of Hebron.
Kuri uyu musozi wa Hebron,
on this mountain of Hebron,
ariwo Africa,
which is Africa.
Dukeneye bafite umutima wa Kalebu.
They'll bring God in the education sphere. They'll bring God in celebrations. God in their festivals.
Conferences.
God in their conferences. It will begin with God. And it will end with God. Nothing will work without prayer. Nothing will end without prayer.
Conference.
It will begin with prayer. If it's about AIDS,
they will
start with prayer. When they end the conference, they will end with prayer. It's not in the church. It is in a conference meeting where we see that God is there. When children go to school, the teacher will begin with prayer.
Congo.
They are bringing the vaccines from Belgium. Others
Ebola iriyo.
And America has no Ebola.
Mu Bubiligi nta Ebola iriyo.
There's no Ebola in
the Congo. Abanyekongo.
How come the Congolese?
Bategereza abanyaburaya kuzana urukingo.
Wait for the Europeans to bring the vaccine.
Imana igiye kuzamura abana bayo.
God is raising his children.
Abanyafrika.
Africans.
Urukingo rw'umubiligi ruhagera ibihumbi byapfuye.
The vaccines from Europe come on thousands have already died.
Kandi rukaza ruhenze.
And it comes very expensive.
Nifite umuti wa malaria.
In the name of Jesus.
God has just
precious mineral that will be invented, that will be used across the world.
Umuti ukomeye kandi urambye ugiye kirekire uzakomoka muri Congo, uzakiza ibiza byinshi, indwara nyinshi zizaguye muri Afrika, muri Congo.
Are you hearing me? In Nigeria, in Nigeria there will be a spaceship that will go to, that will go up, that will compete with other spaceships from Europe and the US. Nigeria is going to work with Israel.
Bazakorana mu bufunguzi bukomeye bujyanye na aerospace, ibiyogajuru byo hejuru.
Nigeria is going to partner with Israel and they will work together in aerospace engineering.
Mu myaka iri imbere,
in the years to come,
muri Afrika sinza hariyo haza hari umusozi uzapfumuka mu amazi, abantu bazabuka mu gitondo basange harimo amazi atemba, abantu benshi bazajya kuri ayo mazi bazakira indwara z'umubiri z'uruhu.
Or shower in that water, or drink that water, they'll find healing for skin conditions or skin diseases. People with skin conditions will be saved from their disease because of that water that saved the Lord. There is hope.
Listen
to what God wants to give us. The help.
Come forward.
The last gospel will come in Africa. Who can rise up?
Who can rise up?
Joshua
zari muri Kalebu.
And when Caleb